That tour was really interesting, don't you think?
Please show me the last minutes of my life. What will bring death to my house?
No, no, no! It can't be true! My own son!
Dear Royal Advisor, I'm obligated to report some unpleasant news to you. King Richard is seriously ill. The Hewas have tried their best to establish the real cause of his illness, but all their attempts have been fruitless. They say such an ailment may be the work of dark magic. The King insisted that you come. He knows about the Swamp Witch incident, and that's why he believes you are the best inspector in the Magic Supervision Department.
Keep me abreast of his condition. I must be the first to know if he gets better or... Now, I have some business to attend to.
Hello, I'm Clarice, the King's healer. That was Andreas, the King's younger brother. I'm sorry he was so brusque with you, but who can blame him?
I was looking forward to your arrival. I'm afraid the healers have exhausted their knowledge, and so have I.
You are the King's last hope. Would you be so kind as to examine the King? If you learn anything new, please leave me a report of your findings. Please. It brings back the King's most painful memories. The King was going to celebrate his birthday. He was in a buoyant mood and even made some jokes. That day, Richard had a slight fever, nothing out of the ordinary.
Neither the court's physician, nor any of our best Imperial healers, could identify the King's illness. They look terrible. Many years ago, Richard was very interested in his descendant's destiny. He knew that the magic mirror could show one's future. But Richard didn't like what he saw. His own son was going to betray him and usurp the throne. However, the king wasn't able to kill his child. Banishment was the only option. Someone wants to take advantage of the heir's apparent absence and usurp the throne. Andreas is the next legitimate claimant. Maybe he's the one who enchanted the king. In the Misty Forest, there is a dark magic expert who may be able to help Richard. Based on your report, I don't think we have another option. As you have already proven your competence and your loyalty to the crown, I think you should be the one to visit him. I'll stay here and take care of the king.
These monsters hate fire. Find something to scare it off.
Thanks for the help. That was some quick thinking with that torch.
I didn't have a chance to introduce myself. I'm Roald, an expert in the field of dark magic. I think I'm the one you've been looking for. I'll get to the bottom of this mystery regarding the king's poisoning. A special ritual will unveil the truth. But I'll need you to bring me some things first. I'll be waiting inside. Surprised you are here, asking for my help. I've been studying dark magic for a long time. must arrest Andreas and get a hold of his spellbook. He'll use it to make poison. We'll use it to make an antidote and cure the king. The guards won't let us in, so we have to distract them and sneak in. Here, take this. It may be helpful. Look at this wall. It's a pity we don't have anything explosive at our disposal. It'll take them about 10 minutes to put out the fire. We have to act fast and find Andreas' spellbook. I'll go first. Follow me.
Thank you.
says that Andreas hid the spellbook in his secret hideout and fled.
An intruder has gotten into the residence.
They're coming. We need to hide.
Nothing. This intruder is one step ahead of us. Well, let's search the area. He couldn't have gone far.
Andreas' hideout is on the Misty Island. The only way to get there is by boat. The faster, the better. The king will die if we don't get that spellbook. I'll go and have a look around. Here, take this. You never know when it may come in handy. say these waters are extremely dangerous. The legend of this place chill folks to the bone. The road takes too long. We need to search Andreas's hideout and find this spellbook as fast as possible. Its tentacles are dragging us down. We have to get rid of them somehow. I can't hear your ideas, my friend. It's just a bit noisy over here. No! That Now we can go. Damned monster slowed us down. We'd better hurry. The king's fading fast. That is what we are looking for. Andreas's hideout. The clock is ticking. We'd better split up and search the castle. One of us is sure to find the spellbook. Excellent. Now I know the antidote type. Let's go. We need to save the king.
King Richard is getting worse. Please, do something.
Do you recognize my face, Your Majesty? Or should I call you father? I'm your son, the one you banished from your own home. Today, I will have my revenge for all the years I've spent in exile. And worked. I conspired with Roald from the very beginning. I'll help him get revenge for his years in exile, and then we'll rule the kingdom together. And now, you and all of the king's confidence will be executed. It's nothing personal. Goodbye.
Hello, I'm Joseph. I can't fall asleep without my sleeping potion, so I always take it with me. If you pour it into the god's glass...
prisoners have escaped.
You should hide somewhere. I'll distract him.
Well, here's one. Let's take him to the square. We can't delay the execution anymore. And we have to find the second prisoner. I don't think he has gone far.
As your new king, I hereby decree that everyone in Richard's court shall be put to death. Executioner, come forward.
ready to execute the criminal?
It's the fugitives! Catch them!
Run, to the carriage, quick! Water is too deep for us to ford the river. I thank you for saving me. We are still in danger. The guards will be here soon. We have to find a hideout and wait them out there. Find something to barricade the door. Quick! Safe. Now we can have a rest. The guards must have left by now. I'll go and check. Be able to dress the wound without that medicine. Please, get my back back.
is some medicine in my bag. Please, find it.
He found my bag. I've long suspected that Andreas is a traitor. I suspect that everything that's happened these last few days is connected to that mirror somehow. Good luck, and take this.
Tell me everything you know about that charmed mirror. This is a direct order coming from Andreas himself.
I won't tell you anything, Clarice.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you for helping me. But I worry that he may have found a way to fake prophecies. I know you're the chief inspector in the magic supervision department.
Andreas, I'm sorry. I didn't manage to find any information on the mirror.
Never mind, Clarice. I'll handle this later. And now, you are to prepare everything for the coronation. After I've finished things in my chambers, I'll join you.
I am Archibald. If you're interested in the history of the royal family. The history of the royal family is shrouded in mystery. The sad truth is hidden there.
We must tie Andreas up as soon as possible, otherwise he'll attack us.
You won't be able to prove a thing!
We need to scour this room for any evidence that can prove Andreas faked the prophecy.
Thank you.
Andreas has charmed the mirror, using forbidden black magic to make Richard quarrel with his own son. It turns out that if Rald hadn't been banished, he would have gone against his father and killed him. Andreas never intended for Rald to actually become king. He soaked the crown with a poison. As soon as Rald puts the crown on his head, he'll drop dead.
Ha ha! The coronation has already started, and soon the new king will be dead. You won't prove a thing.
Oh, get to the main hall and stop the coronation. In the meantime, I'll be holding Andreas back. I won't let him escape.
time to begin the coronation. I'll officiate.
Guards!
Blasted traitor! You'll pay for that.
Stop, all of you. I've just escaped from the dungeon where Roald was keeping me, but I'm here to defend my son.
Father, I only kept you imprisoned to make everybody think you were dead. I couldn't bring myself to kill you. Why are you standing up for me now?
You can't imagine how much I regret everything I've done to you. Banishing you was the biggest mistake of my life. I'm so sorry.
Forgive you, Father.
Oh, Roald, your father only banished you because his magic mirror told him that you would betray him. Oh, but that prophecy was faked. Andreas did it to get rid of the royal family and take the throne for himself. Ah, who knows what would have happened if the king hadn't summoned you.
I am eternally grateful to you. The entire kingdom owes you a great debt. As for Andreas, he'll rot in a prison cell forever. After so many years, my dear son Roald, the heir apparent to the throne, is finally here by my side.
Thank you. Thank you to each and every one of you for coming here today. I raise this glass of wine to you all.
Lord! Oh, Lord! What's happening to him? Guards! Cordon off the area! Royal Advisor, you're here! Please bring a stretcher! We need to get Roald to the healer! Your son. How could this happen?
Roald was fine earlier today. He couldn't have gotten sick in just the last hour. Someone must have poisoned him. Go to the Royal Library, learn more about the poison, and track down the bastard who dared commit this atrocity. I'll stay and look after my son. Take Roald's riding griffin to get there fast. Make sure to pour the poison into the vial. Otherwise, you'll spill it along the way. Here, it's the griffin's favorite. Good luck. I see you've identified the poison. This fern looks like the one I ordered from the neighboring kingdom as a little gift for Roald's mother. She adored flowers. This fern isn't naturally dangerous, so I never imagined a poisoner could make use of it. Go to the royal garden. My servants planted it there. Maybe there are some clues this awful person left. Meet me in the castle later, and let me know what you find.
What a mess. There must have been a fire in the garden. Poor Iris has fainted. We need to help her as soon as possible. You are the royal advisor, aren't you? Could you please make a healing potion for my sister? I'll stay here and look after her in the meantime.
What? Oh, I wonder who did this to me, and what does that scent remind me of? Come to think of it, here's my advice. Pay a visit to Padme. I believe she has some explaining to do. And here, take this brooch. It might come in handy.
I know why you're here. Iris sent you to kill me so that I don't expose the plot she cooked up with her sister. Unfortunately for you, I came prepared. You? How did you manage to get out? Wait, your face looks familiar now. You're the royal advisor, aren't you? Sorry about that whole sleeping potion incident. I arrived in this kingdom not so long ago, so I don't know many people here. I thought you were in some kind of conspiracy with Beatrice and Iris. They're the ones behind Roald's poisoning. While Roald was in exile, Richard was so desperate for an heir that he promised to put Fitz, the king, and Beatrice's bastard son on the throne. When Roald came back and Richard reinstated his claim, Beatrice was beside herself. She conspired with his sister Iris to poison her son's only rival for the throne. But when I arrived at the palace, I accidentally overheard their conversation. I didn't know that Roald had already been poisoned, so I destroyed the recipe, hoping to save the prince. Thank God. Now I can entrust this matter to you. And here, take this as an apology. Take care of yourself.
Thank you. friend you have. Well, I respect your determination.
Fortune smiles on you today. These damn guards have closed the gates, and I have nowhere to run. You win. I surrender.
Thank you. I couldn't do it without your help. The evidence you've collected is irrefutable. The guilty will be punished. Iris made an antidote. Beatrice gave it to me in exchange for her life.